So we are flying over the June 27th Kilauea lava flow with a unmanned aerial vehicle, or a UAV. This is called the Swinglet Cam. It's made by Sensefly, and it's a we use it for mapping. So we have a lithium polymer battery that powers it. It's a LiPo battery, and basically this is if you're ever familiar with if you've ever flown radio control aircraft before, that's basically what this technology is. So it's RC technology. You have a motor and a prop. You have your ailerons. This is called a flying wing airframe. So it doesn't have a rudder. It takes its ailerons and combines it with an elevator, like a traditional airplane, but mixes the two into one. So it just has two wings, and we call these elevons. And this is our airspeed sensor right here. It's the pitot tube. So we can, it's a really cool process once it's up in the air. So what happens is it's gliding along and it flies autonomously. The flight controller, or the autopilot, which is embedded right here, keeps it stable in the air. And just before it's going to take a photo, there's a camera right here in the center. And this is a pretty much standard point-and-shoot camera that's connected to the flight controller. And just before it's going to take a photo, it'll stabilize itself. It'll kill the motor. And based on its airspeed ratings, it'll slow down and then take the photo. And then the motor will kick in. It'll speed back up, go to its next geotag photo location, and then slow down and take another photo. And it'll do this repeatedly until it has a hundreds. So on average, today we're flying about 300. We're collecting about 300 photos per flight, and we'll take those photos. And these photos are overlapping each other. So the flight line is kind of like a lawnmower. It's mowing the air, so to speak, with photography, and it's just gonna go back and forth, just kind of like you're mowing your yard. Just gonna go back and forth, and these photos are overlapping so that we can tie them together into what we call a mosaic. And this is where you're stitching the photographs into one large image, and it's very high resolution, lots of details, so you can zoom in different places. But the other really cool thing, and the reason we're out here today, is we're creating surface models of the active flow. And we're trying to measure the inflation rates of the flow remotely from the air with just imagery taken by the UAV. And we're comparing that with our field measurements from the ground.